Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So 2 years back, before Corona was even a thing, is when I shared my last budgeting video with all of you. And it got a lot of love. But since then, a lot of things have changed in my life. For example, I'm in a new house, so my rent has changed. And a lot of other things as well. So in today's video, I'm going to share with you my real budget with real numbers so that you get a clear idea about where all of my money goes, where I spend my money, how I spend my money, and all of those details. So if you're nosy like me, then make sure that you stick around for this video till the very end and let's get started. So of course, every budget video starts with the income. So in my case, I actually run my own company, right? I'm the CEO of my own organization and my company makes a certain amount of money every month. That changes obviously, but the whole income that my company makes is not my income. I am like any other employee in my organization, so I get a fixed monthly salary every month. And this salary is what accounts towards my income. So my company makes money through YouTube channel, through my courses, through my physical products, digital products, and all of that. But no matter how much that money is, I get a fixed amount, and that is 2 lakh rupees per month after taxes. So after the TDS deduction and everything, the money that comes into my hand is 2 lakh rupees, and that's my monthly salary. Now, after the income, the next big thing that we tackle in any budget are fixed expenses. Fixed expenses are your essential expenses that you have to make every month no matter what, like your rehna khana and all of that, right? Whether you have a job, whichever state of life you are in, you will want to spend on a ghar, on food and stuff like that. So my fixed expenses are actually, they are the biggest chunk of my budget. So I'll give you a breakdown of that. Number one is rent. Now, you guys know that I moved to this villa, and if you haven't seen the tour of this villa, the video for that is in the description box below. So this is a 5-bedroom, 3-hall villa that we moved to recently. We've come to such a big place because we have a lot of people now living with us in our family. So this villa is obviously a little bit more expensive than what my previous apartment was, given that it's significantly bigger and it's in the middle of the city and all of that. So for this villa, we are currently paying 80,000 rupees per month as rent, and this includes the maintenance as well. But things are a little tricky here. You see, this house is not just used as my residential place, meaning I live here, yes, but I also use this place as my office. So it makes sense for me to not pay the whole rent just out of my own pocket. So 50% of the rent is paid by me and my family, and the rest 50% is paid by my company. So my company pays 40,000 rupees as rent and I pay 40,000 rupees as rent. So for me, essentially, including maintenance and everything, the amount that I pay to live in this beautiful house is 40,000 rupees a month. The next big expense I have is my domestic help. I have an amazing, amazing woman who comes to my place every morning at 9 a.m, leaves in the evening, and basically is at our place the whole day and helps us with literally everything. Cleaning, cooking, and everything that you have to do to run a good household. And she is excellent at her job, and I absolutely love her for everything she does for us. So because this is kind of like the only job she has, she goes to one other place in the evening, but essentially most of her income comes from our house. So we pay her 20,000 rupees a month to take care of everything that we need as a family. The third big expense we have is groceries. Every single person in my family is a major foodie, and we love to eat fancy food almost every other day. So for us, groceries is a pretty big expense. We spend 25,000 rupees a month, but this essentially includes everything like organic vegetables, non-veg, atta, chawal, tel, whatever you need to run a kitchen. Next up, we have internet. I essentially run my whole business from this house, so I need to have access to high-speed internet. And given that my whole business is online, internet becomes an absolute essential thing for me. So we have taken ACT Fibernet, which is one of the best internet service providers in Bangalore, and for that we pay 3,000 rupees every month. Next is milk and dairy products. Now that my mom, mom-in-law, and a lot of people live with us, bahut chai banti hai ghar mein, so we need access to a lot of milk. We've subscribed to this thing called Country Delight, which is really good, and we get all of our dairy products from there. And our monthly expense for this comes to about 1,500 rupees. Next up is transport. Now we don't have a car, so our transport bills are relatively higher for compared to those who use only petrol. So we pay Ola and Uber drivers on a regular basis, and our transport bill usually comes to about 5,000 rupees a month. Thoda upar niche happens, but 5,000 on an average is what we spend. This is obviously considering that we are living in Corona times and we don't get to travel as much as we'd like. So right now, at least for the last 1.5 years, it's been around 5,000 rupees. And on a side note, Bangalore airport is really far, so any kind of travel related cab ka kharcha that I have to take is not included in this, because I have to go to airport, it's like 1200 rupees one side for one travel, which is so much. And the last thing we have in our fixed expenses is newspapers and magazines and journals and all of that. But essentially, the only thing that we actually subscribe to is a newspaper, and that's Economic Times. And for that, we pay 300 rupees every month. So that's all of my fixed expenses. Total for that comes up to 97,800 rupees. Now, this may sound like a lot of money, but I don't pay this by myself. This household is run by me and my husband together, and we are equal partners in everything. So 50% of these expenses are taken care of by me, 50% is taken care of by my husband. So on an average, I pay somewhere around 47,400 rupees, which comes to me, and 47,400, which comes to my husband, goes up to about 48, 49, 50,000 sometimes. But on an average, these are all of our fixed expenses. Now, after talking about fixed expenses, most people jump directly to discretionary expenses. But in my opinion, before you go to discretionary expenses, you should talk about your savings and investments first, because if you start making your discretionary expenses, in the end, you'll realize that you have really nothing left. So you take out your investments first and then you think about your discretionary expenses. For most people, an important part of savings and investment is actually contributing to the emergency fund. But thankfully for me and my husband, with years of financial discipline, our emergency fund is completely maxed out, which means we have 6 months of our fixed expenses saved up in a liquid fund and in savings account and everything. So that is taken care of, which means every kind of investment that we do right now is with the intention of growing our fund and basically planning for our retirement. So for me right now, I have a very simple goal. I have to invest 1 lakh rupees every single month, no matter what. So 1 lakh straight out of my income goes towards my investments. And my investments currently are split into three things. There is Indian stock market, which takes 40% of my investments. There's the US stock market, which takes 40% of my investment, and cryptocurrency, which takes 20% of my investments. So the 1 lakh is kind of split into this, and of course the number changes a little bit depending on which market is down, at what point I invest more money there, but this is more or less the split that I have for investments. Now, after all this, I am left with 50,000 rupees every month for my discretionary expenses. I'm free to use this money as I like, but mostly this money typically for anybody is used for eating out, for shopping, for movies, for entertainment, for anything else that you like doing generally in your life. For me, this category is actually a little small, because I've gotten into this mode where I want to be healthy, so I've stopped eating out a lot. For movies as well, I feel like I don't like going to movie hall, at least right now, because of the COVID situation. So discretionary expenses right now are not happening much. So I have 10,000 rupees banked away for anything that I want to spend on in the month. This could be shopping some months, this could be eating out, this could be hosting guests, whatever. 10,000 rupees is what I have earmarked for that. On top of that, 5,000 rupees is petty cash, which I keep with myself for idhar udhar ka kharcha, you know. Sometimes you just have to pay for some things, maybe some tiny repairs here and there in your house or whatever. So I keep 5,000 rupees cash, which I withdraw from ATM and keep with me at all times. And the 35,000 rupees that's left after that is used solely for my travel fund. So I take this amount and I invest it in my liquid mutual funds, where it gets invested regularly on a month-on-month basis. And when the amount becomes significant enough is when I decide to go out and take a trip to wherever I want. Now, 35,000 is not the only contribution that happens to travel fund for my family. 35,000 also comes from my husband. So 70,000 rupees a month is earmarked specifically as travel fund every month. And within 3 to 4 months, we have enough money accumulated, which we can take out and go out and take a nice international travel. So that's it. This is the breakdown of my budget for you. I hope this gave you some clarity. So in terms of percentages, as you saw, 50% of my income straight up goes towards investing, 25% goes towards my needs, which are my fixed expenses, and 25% goes towards my bonds, which are my discretionary expenses. But if you're someone who's just starting out with a budgeting process, you can start with something simpler, which is 50% towards your needs, your fixed expenses, 30% towards your wants, which are your discretionary expenses, and 20% towards investments to get started. But ideally, you should try and move towards where I am right now. And yeah, that's it. I hope you found this video useful. Please share this with somebody who would find this useful as well. Give this a big thumbs up, subscribe, and I'll see you next time. Bye.